impressive. So I was happy for him. Yeah. Happy for me, you know, because I thought he locked it down over there.
What about
Omar? Did you guys really have something to prove after what happened against Belgium, especially the anniversary game?
Always. I mean, I think that's always the motivation of any team when you take a loss. It happens everywhere. It happens every week with your club team and with your national team. And the most important thing is trying to bounce back and be motivated. And we did that.
How were the center backs today? I mean, you've worked with them before in Mexico. Got another shot today. Led in three goals, but it didn't seem like
I thought they did well. I did. There's obviously things we can correct and things we can work on. Then we got tired towards the end. Yeah. You know, I think they were tired too, but obviously they had to push. You know, I think it's important that there's a certain maturity about a performance when you're up 4-1. To try and see it out and not put pressure on yourself. One step at a time, though. You know, I think that was good. I think they headed their lines clear. I thought they kept a good line at times, so that was positive. I just try, especially because they're young, I try and encourage them to talk. I talk all the time, and I think it's an important element for guys in the back to always have open line of communication, and they're getting better.
How important is it getting
business cards? There's a lot more running work. I think we just got a little bit tired, but that's just about maturity, you know. As perfectionists, you know, it's never going to be exactly how we want it.
Right back.
A lot of the game, defensively, we dominated again. We kept it kind of where we wanted them. So
before they go, I think we talked about it.
Again, as it got later on, we got tired, and they had to push and
being aggressive.
They took the chances.
About Brad.
Won all of his 1v1 duels.
I thought it was
better simple too.
I thought they were tighter, so more compact.
For us,
well, still to mature. I think back four has to play together. There's no substitute for that. You don't get it just in training. You have to play games. You have to take your moments.
You only play one game at right back.
It's not easy, you know. But
he's learning the position
all the time.
He's got everything
to be busy, to constantly communicate or talking to each other. But it's a work in progress.
Would you earlier in camp maybe the same
That's all. That's obviously. It's always nice to see consistency.
But when you look at the first half, it's not easy.
You know, with injuries and guys in different stages coming off the season, it's yellow cards, injuries, all that stuff. It plays a part. So it's never perfect. But from a master's standpoint, rarely do you get that.
You and I talked the other day about Josie a little bit. What did you see from him? The goals
that
said this is going to
be why. He took the goal well, took the goal great, actually. Then there was another moment in the first half where he shifted and hit him and the keeper made a save to the left. You know, all those things, he's still really composed. You know, I think sometimes we get strikers, who are put under pressure, they get a bit jittery, and he hasn't shown that. But having said that, he had a great year. You know, he's full of confidence, and I think there's been a lot made of nothing. You know, he scored a bag full of goals this year. More than a bag full of goals. So, driven by the guys coming off a great season, so he's still very confident.
He seemed to do a lot today, actually, as a target man, holding up.
His touch was really good. He came off the back four. We linked up play. It was a tough field. It was sticky. It was dry. So, a lot of times the ball bounces up, and his touches were really good. You know, we played into him. He's playing balls around the corner, playing balls back in the feet. So, he's our big man. We're going to ride him. So, he knows that, and he embraces it. Second balls and third balls, and it's important to have a tandem in there, guys who understand each other, who understand that if one's going to go, one's got to stay, and it's like one is the other's right arm. You have to be in unison, and they do that really well.
Talk about the physical presence that you provide.
Well, I think every team needs a guy who's going to push the tempo, who's going to not be afraid to get stuck in. Jermaine goes really well.
Down 4-3 in the last 10 minutes. How do you feel about that? What's going through your head?
Just trying to stay calm and composed, trying to put people in the right spots. Obviously, something's not going right, so I'm trying to slow the tempo down, get everybody concentrated again, focus, try to see the game out.
Thank you very much.